Burglary is a serious crime and a dangerous undertaking for the perpetrator and his victim. Even though burglars prefer to commit their cowardly acts when there is no one around, this is not always the case, and oftentimes someone gets hurt, usually the burglar. During 2011, it is estimated that 1,063 burglaries were recorded in the city of Gainesville. There were an estimated 197 arrests made for this crime, which resulted in many convictions, sending young men and women to serve time in prison. The odds are, if you do a burglary today, you're going to be identified, apprehended, and placed into custody. This is due to the modern investigatory techniques employed and the forensic tools and processes used today to identify individuals involved in burglaries and other crimes.
Not too much different. You may think that it may be an opportune time to just slip on in when the door is unlocked, but the consequences are the same. You are committing a felony.
Hey guys, get on the ground. Get on the ground. You know what I say? Get on the ground right now. Put your hands out in front of you where I can see them. Put your hands out where I can see them. Both hands. Run straight out in front of you. Lay down flat. Lay your face down on the ground. Alright. Okay. My hands got you.
It is important to know that you don't have to remove anything during a burglary to be charged with a felony. Often, burglars are apprehended at the crime scene before they have an opportunity to escape with stolen property. In these instances, they are charged with breaking and entering with the intent to commit theft. So what started out as a good idea, you know, taking someone's property, most often turns out for the burglar to be a bad choice that can have a negative effect on his or her life for a very long time. Just ask the judge.